we would like to show you one of the nicest swimming holes in North Florida, Gilchrist Blue Springs State Park near Gainesville. This is Florida's newest state park and home of several springs, including Blue Springs, which is a second magnitude spring that discharges about 44 million gallons of crystal clear water every day. It's pretty close to home for us and was a great place to celebrate Rhonda's birthday. The campground is small and doesn't even have a dump station yet, but the water's great and it's very close. Gilchrist Blue Springs State Park. This is why it exists. It's just amazing how crystal clear the water is. Even on a busy Sunday afternoon, you can see all the way across the spring, which, just guessing, is a couple hundred feet underwater. It's about $22 a night to camp there with water and electric. We enjoyed three nights and went in the water every day and didn't get bored. They rent kayaks, canoes, and paddle boards. It's about a quarter mile out to the beautiful Santa Fe River, where you can see the real Florida. On the weekends, that you can have a vendor pick you up for several different floating trips where you don't have to paddle uphill.
Comes the sea monster.
There are certainly bigger springs and much more technical springs where you can cave dive and get lost underwater. But this one's great for just swimming, just enjoying the beautiful spring out in the woods, and maybe even going down to the river. Janice, why aren't you in the water?
Because it's too cold. I'm in up to my knees. Here, stick your stuff right on there. I am not sitting down on that thing.
I'm videoing you paddling.
Yes. Well, I had to get wet. I had to go swimming before I got in the kayak because I didn't want to be so hot, you know.
Which was probably a smart idea.
So, we're just starting out on our kayak trip from Gilchrist Blue Springs, and we're going to go up to Poe Springs. It's really pretty, this little inlet here.
Water's so crystal clear. You really don't have a feel for how deep it is. Rhonda was going and we really couldn't even tell if she was going to make it over this log, but she did. So right here you can see where the clear water and the darker water meet. So this is the Santa Fe River. We're going to paddle upstream. This river and the Suwannee River are both more tannic. They got that brown color, and that is from the oak trees on the sides. Wow, that's a big cypress. So apparently it used to be clear water here too, but all the pine trees that were pines and cypress that were originally along the rivers got cut and the oaks took over and it tannified. We're at Rum Island, which I think is a county park, and it's closed.
Here's the spring at Rum Island Springs. You can tell where the water comes up. Right there, there's the big hole. It's not quite as crystal clear as the spring we're staying at, but it's very nice.
Some homes along here. Kind of a funky deck, but I'm sure it's built useful. For sale over there. And some more kayakers coming around the corner. Really having to work hard to keep going forward. Over there's the Poe Springs. Well, Rhonda, we made it.
Yeah, we did. Chicken salad for lunch. I forgot the spoon, so we're eating with our fingers.
Show me.
Luckily, it's, yeah.
It's good anyway.
It's good. That was a tough paddle. It's about 2 miles upstream.
Uphill the whole way.
And there was a couple of places where the current was pretty tough. Yeah, we had to really concentrate and get through there. It was good, though. Now we're going to relax and swim in the spring.
And then float back.
Mm-hmm. Joe's not too far ahead of me, but you can see how wide the river is here.
Yes, Rhonda, this is much better.
Sun's nice and bright. It's hot,
hot,
but we're going in the right direction. It was a hard slog to get up to Poe Springs, which is a county park. About a 2 mile against the current paddle.
Mm-hmm. We've had our Thoraxis about a year now. We bought it last year in September or August, right near my birthday. And I have to say, we have really enjoyed it. We really like the outdoors. We like having our own little home on wheels to go to different places. We were able to bring our kayaks this time because we only live about 45 miles from this campground. So I drove the motorhome over and Joe came over with the kayaks in the back of the truck. We haven't been able to bring the kayaks on the car.
These are actually rapids. Not sure where that water's coming from. But it's pretty cool. Cypress knees. Really cool.
Jeez, they don't care.
Tell us about your trip, dear.
It was wonderful, but I'm pretty tired. It was 2 miles up against the current. My back is a little sore, but other than that, I'm just fine.
It's a really tight campsite. You don't really come here for camping. You come here for swimming. Surprising how many people are here. Another little weirdness. We backed in. The utilities are on the wrong side. We backed in because if we would have pulled in, there was somebody camped right there. So we would have been face to face with them. So right on the other side of those pavilions is where the spring is. Very nice. Short walk. We used the Wii Boost. We really had crappy signal. It was marginal Netflix, YouTube, real low resolution last night. I think a lot of it just depended on usage of the tower. One of the negatives for the park is the entrance road. It's over a mile of sandy washboard dirt road. It took Rhonda over 9 minutes to drive the 1.13 miles. In a future video, we'll be highlighting the rivers and springs of Florida. They're well worth the effort to see the real Florida.
Thanks for watching, and be sure to like the video and subscribe if you're new to our channel.
Feel free to leave us a comment and tell us what you think. We'll be happy to respond.